everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing some trapezoidal rule problems today. The trapezoidal rule is one way to estimate the area under a graph or under the curve, between the curve and the x-axis. So, the problem that we're given is the integral of dx over 1 plus x squared on the range negative 1 to 2, where n equals 6. So this is the function that we're given. The trapezoidal rule, we have to remember, is from a to b of fx dx equals, so this is left hand side here is representing our function. So they're saying, given a function like this one, which ours is, right? We have a range a to b and then some function here. Then we apply the following formula. It's f of x 0 plus 2 f of x 1 plus 2 f x 2 plus dot 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 plus 2 f of x n minus 1. This formula, I hate formulas like this, they're so ridiculous, but this is the way it's written out, and it looks so intimidating, but it's actually so simple. I just hate it when we write stuff like this and make it way more complicated than it is. But anyway, so this is the formula that we're given, and basically all it's saying is that, well, the first thing we need to do, let's forget about the formula for now. The first thing we have to do is find delta x. So that's always your first step. And the way that we find delta x, or the change in x, is to use the number of trapezoids that they have already told us they want us to use, and the range, negative 1 to 2. So they've told us that they want us to divide the range, negative 1 to 2, into 6 different trapezoids. So if our graph, right, is like this, and here's negative 1, and here's 2, they want us to divide this into 6 sections. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, oh, missed 1, 5, 6, right? So they want us to have, if our graph looks like this or something, they want us to divide this into these 6 trapezoids so that we can, you know, do something like that to approximate the area. But anyway, it's actually really simple. All we do is to find delta x, we do the top number minus the bottom number, 2 minus negative 1, and we divide by n, which they've given us. So we've got 2 minus negative 1, which is actually 2 plus 1, which is 3, over 6. So delta x is, oopsies, delta x is 1 half. So given that delta x is 1 half, now we need to write down what these values are. So, like here, 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 all the way through. We need to write down what those values are. So the first one obviously is negative 1. The first one is always the bottom number. The last one is always the top number. But x of 0 will be the first number, negative 1, and this bottom number here. And then we just keep writing, right? X1, since delta x, or the change in x, is 1 half, we add 1 half to the previous number each time. So this will actually be 1 half, or negative 1 plus 1 half is negative 1 half. And then x2 would be 0, we add 1 half again. X3 would be 1 half. X4 would be 1. X5 would be 3 halves, or 1 and a half, and x6 would be 2. We've gotten to 2, which is our upper limit here and the last number here. So we know that we've found all the values of x. This is our range, right? Negative 1 to 2. And we have a change, a delta x, of 1/2 each time. So these are our values of x that we're going to use to plug into this function. See, we have x0, x1, x2, on and on and on, all the way to xn. See, x of n, n is 6, and we've got x of 6 here. So that's why we found these values. So you just find delta x, then you write down your first value as x0 is the bottom number. You add delta x each time until you get to the second number or the top number here, and then you're done. You know you have all your x values. So now that we have that, we can go ahead and apply this formula. Forget about this. You don't need it because that just represents our function. So just forget about that. This, right, f of x0. So what this means is, here's x0, right? x0 is negative 1. That means we're plugging in negative 1 to our function here. So we plug negative 1 in. So this is the same thing as 1 over 1 plus x squared dx, right? Dx is just, since they're multiplied together, they put dx on the top. But this, we can completely ignore the dx. All we care about is this right here, 1 over 1 plus x squared. So our trapezoidal formula here is going to be negative 1 plugged into this function. So we'll have 1 over 1 plus negative 1 squared. And then we plug in the second one, and we go all the way through. So let's see, negative 1/2. So we've got 1 over 1 plus negative 1/2 squared. And I hope that's large enough that you can kind of read it. But I plugged in negative 1/2 here. See, though, that we have this 2. We have another 2, got another 2. We have to multiply this by 2 because the formula has it there. So then we keep going. We've got a 2 on the next one. So we do 2 times 1 over 1 plus 0 squared plus 2 times 1 over 1/2. 1 plus 1/2 squared, and I'm going to go ahead, kind of running out of room, I'll write it on the second line here. So we'll have plus, we did 1/2, so 1 over, and we've actually, we need to multiply that by 2, 1 over 1 plus 1 squared plus 2 times 1 over 1 plus 3/2 squared plus 1 over 1 plus 2 squared. Okay, and then we've got delta x. We said delta x, right, was 1/2. We solved for it up there already. 1/2 over 2. Okay, so I wanted to just get the whole formula written out and then kind of explain afterwards. The reason I hate this formula is because it looks confusing, but all it's saying is that, and I can go ahead and erase this now so that our board looks a little less terrifying. All it's saying is that you multiply every term after the first term and before the last term by 2. So you can see that our first term is not multiplied by 2, and our last term is not multiplied by 2. Every other term in between is multiplied by 2. And that's all it means. You've got delta x at the end here. You always divide by 2. That's part of the formula. So delta x over 2. And then you just go term by term based on what you wrote down for x, which we did negative 1, negative 1/2, 0, 1/2, 1, all the way up to 2. You just plug that in to your function here, and you multiply all the terms in the middle by 2. Not the first one, not the last one. And that's all it means. So Even though this formula looks really stupid, it's actually easier than you'd think. So now that we've done this, let's go ahead and simplify. So the first term, right, we've got 1 over, we'll need a parenthesis here, negative 1 squared is just 1, so 1 plus 1 on the bottom there is 2, right? Yeah, so we got 2 on the bottom, and then we have 2 times negative 1 half squared is positive 1 fourth, plus 1 is 5 fourths, so that's actually going to be 2 times 4 fifths, because 1 divided by a fraction is the same thing as 1 multiplied by the inverse of that fraction, so since we had 1 over 5 fourths, that's the same thing as 1 times 4 fifths, which of course is just 4 fifths, so we have 2 times 4 fifths, plus 2 times 0 squared is just 0, so we have 1 over 1, which is just 1, so of course 2 times 1 is just 2, so I'm just going to leave that as 2. We did that one, and that one. 1 half squared is 1 fourth, plus 1 is 5 fourths, 1 divided by 5 fourths is 4 fifths, so plus 2 times 4 fifths again. That one, 1 squared is 1, so we've got 1 plus 1 is 2, so that's 1 half, so plus 2 times 1 half is just 1. 3 halves squared is going to be 9 fourths plus 1, so we've got 4 fourths plus 9 fourths is 13 fourths. 1 divided by 13 fourths is the same as 4 over 13. So plus 2 times 4 over 13. And then 2 squared is 4, plus 1 is 5. 1 over 5 there. And then, of course, that whole thing multiplied by 1 half divided by 2 is just 1 fourth. So I know that simplification was quick, but you guys can do the same thing on your calculator. Trapezoidal problems, you almost always end up solving with your calculator. You almost always end up with a decimal because the fraction is really ugly. So you could just do the whole thing on your calculator, but I'm just showing you guys in my head. So 1 half plus 8 fifths plus 2 plus 8 fifths plus 1 plus 8 thirteenths plus 1 fifth times 1 fourth. So in this case, I could simplify. I'll do 1 half, and then I'm going to combine this 8 fifths, 8 fifths, and 1 fifth. So that's 16 17 fifths. I'm just going to do this because it makes it easier to plug into my calculator. And then I have 2 plus 1 is 3, so plus 3 plus 8 over 13 times 1 fourth. So now that I've gotten this down to something that's easier, I'll go ahead and plug this into my calculator. So I'll just do 1 divided by 2 plus 17 divided by 5 plus 3 plus 8 divided by 13, and I'll get that answer, and then I will just divide that whole thing by 4, which is the same thing, obviously, as multiplying by 1 fourth. So I divide that whole thing by 4, and I get, as my final answer, 8788, and it gives you more decimal places, but you could round to 4. I think that would be sufficient. So I know maybe a little bit confusing, a lot of stuff written on the board, but that is basically in a nutshell how you apply the trapezoidal formula, and your final answer is 1.8788. Thanks, guys. See you next time.